friends, welcome back to my channel. As you can see, I am not in my typical setup. I am at my parents' house this weekend visiting them, and I have a really fun vlog for you planned, which is week in the life of a software developer, as you know, and we are going through a really cool interactive art exhibit this week, which I'm really excited to take you on. What else are we doing this week? I'm really excited. I'm gonna sit down with you actually shortly here and answer a ton of different questions you asked me related to coding and career and all of the above. So make sure to stay tuned. Lots of good things coming up. Before we get started though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding content. Give this video a thumbs up. Shout out to some of these amazing subscribers. Thank you for your comments, questions, feedback, you know, all of the above. You all are amazing. Okay, come on, let's go. Okay, I am just on my way to meet Carol. That's Paul's mom. For those of you who don't know, we're going to have some lunch at the Fairmont Royal York, which is a famous hotel here in Toronto. And then we are going to go to this really cool art exhibit, and I'm really excited to take you along with it, with me on it. It's by Monet. The art is by Monet, and it's this interactive kind of exhibit. So you're like in the art, or the art is living. Sounds really cool. I'm really excited. So I'll take you along there too to see the exhibit. Oh, and I wanted to show you, look at this top I got. Okay, so it says, you know, I love vintage kind of tees. Eat, sleep, compute. It's kind of nerdy, but I really like it. I think it's kind of cute. Anyways, okay, let's go. Okay, so I just got to the Royal York to have some lunch. We can dine inside now, finally, in Canada, so I will show you where we're eating. Okay, so now I am back at the airport and flying to Saskatchewan, back to home. Going home for Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving in Canada is in October, not November, so I'm gonna go home for a few days. Okay, so I just made it to Regina. It was about a 3-hour flight. It was a really small plane, so I feel like, sorry, there's so much sun coming in. I'm just happy to be on the ground, let's just say that. I got my rental vehicle, which I got upgraded, so that's kind of nice. So I still have, because I live in a smaller city, I grew up in a city of 16,000, so maybe for some of you that's really small, for some of you that's probably not that small, but growing up it felt really small, and so there's no airport there, so I have to drive 2.5 hours now to get home to see my family for Thanksgiving. So it is kind of a really long day of driving and flying, but it'll be nice to be there for 3 nights and just kind of relax and do that. Although I do miss Paul and the dogs already, but anyways, okay, let's get driving. Okay, so I just got home a while ago, and I'm going to take a night to the evening, pretty relaxed, low-key, gonna hang out with my parents, cook some dinner, and watch a movie.
kind of not very exciting, but I'm kind of tired from the drive, so looking forward to just kind of unwinding for a bit.
Okay, so I made it home, as you know, and I'm just sitting down with some coffee, and I want to come and get personal with you and answer some questions you asked me on my Instagram earlier today that I didn't get to answering, and there's some really amazing questions, so I put them on my computer here, and we're going to go through them. First question. In my first year studying CS in college, In my first year studying CS in college, but I don't know if it's right for me. How did you know? This is a great question. How do you know if computer science is right for you or if you are in the right industry? Well, I think there's a few things. First of all, the biggest piece of advice is when you're in school or in your first year of university, it's going to feel very overwhelming. So it might not be the best representation of if you like computer science or not. So I think the best thing you can do, if possible, is, especially if you are in university, is take this time to intern. Do as much internships as possible, because for me, that was the best way to find out and discover what I liked and didn't like. And I think it's a great way as well to network and meet people. And even if you do an internship in something that ends up not being what you are passionate about, that's still really valuable experience that you can use. Okay, next question. What is next question here? What do you do when you don't feel productive? Oh my gosh, I don't feel productive like so much, but there's this thing, what is it? I'll put it up on the screen here, but there's this new thing that they're saying about motivation, that motivation doesn't really exist or all the time. It's kind of a myth, and it's more that you just have to be disciplined, and I really think there's so much truth to that. There's going to be so many days or moments where you don't want to be productive or feel motivated, but you know you need to accomplish something. And that's really when the discipline comes in. For me, getting discipline and finding that discipline, I should say, is by looking at the future Tiff. Like, how is this going to help future Tiff out, whether it be taking this course or learning this new skill? It's not about how I feel now, but how will this benefit the future Tiff? And when I think about her and the future, it really makes me, it kind of brings back that motivation and makes me want to work harder. That being said though, I think it's really important to not burn out. So if you're feeling really unproductive, maybe it's a sign to take some time off, take a step back, maybe take a day to yourself. It's, you know, you don't want to push yourself and burn yourself completely out. Oh, this is a great question. I get asked this question so much. Is it too late to start a career as a front-end developer at 39 with no previous experience in IT? This is a great question. I get asked so much, am I too old to start out in my tech career? Is there ageism in tech? All of the above. And I can only speak from my personal experience, and as someone, I'm 29 by the way, and I got into tech when I was, 23, 24 I think. I can't remember exactly, but a few years ago, and I know that's still really young, but it felt like a weird transition because, you know, my first manager was younger than me, and it's weird, but it's kind of normal in tech because so many people are breaking in at all ages. So first of all, you are not too old to break into tech, whether you are 39, 49, anything. Of course, there are different struggles that come with breaking in at different ages, such as maybe you can't, you know, maybe you have a family you have to take care of, maybe you have other responsibilities, so it's not as easy to break into it, but it's totally possible. And honestly, it's, you know, I think with ageism, I'm curious to know everyone else's thoughts on this, but for me, I don't really think ageism is a thing in tech, but that's just my experience and the companies that I've worked for and coming from someone young. But I think more than anything, just having an open mind, and so many people in tech are very open and just happy that others are breaking in, that you just need to go for it. So to answer your question, go for it, break in. We need so many more people in tech and in IT that there's never an age limit. Okay, this is a great question. Any idea how I can include myself better in a team? I just started as a software dev apprentice and I feel lost. First of all, I've been there. When you feel lost and you're starting out and just like you don't really fit into the team, it kind of sucks. And you feel very alone and it's just not a good feeling. So my advice to you is, if you are in person, if the team is in person, try doing things like going out for coffee with them or going for lunch or different things like that, just to build a rapport. I know some people just want to go to work and not build a relationship, but building even just like a basic level relationship with your colleagues can be super beneficial as to building that level of trust, and also to, it really helps I find, okay, sorry, my camera cut me off, but building that level of trust, and it makes it easier too, I find, when I'm going to ask questions or need help, that I have that level of trust with them. So if possible, just try and build those relationships slowly over time, but I promise you, those feelings you are having will go away with time. It's just always so scary when you first start out in a new position, but congrats on it. Okay, I know I only answered 4 questions, but I feel like I wanted to answer them very in depth. So if you have more questions, leave them down in the comments, as I mentioned, and I will do my best to answer them in this video, like in the comments. And if you want a second part to this video where I just answer more of your questions, let me know. Yeah, okay, I need to go help my mom cook Thanksgiving dinner now, because it's Thanksgiving this weekend in Canada. I know in the States it's November, but this is the weekend in Canada. Okay, thank you for watching this video. I hope you really enjoyed it, and especially the Q&A, I hope you found it useful and helpful. I love doing Q&As with you, so if I didn't answer your question or you have any other questions, leave them down below and I will do my best to answer them. I always try to answer your comments that you leave in these videos, and then if I don't or don't go in as in-depth, I will do a video on them as well. If you haven't already, hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Give this video a thumbs up, and I will see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.